Hello friends, in this video I'll be helping you with the example on Floyd-Warshall algorithm. So let's start. So about this example, till the video ends everything will be fully clear to you, because I'll be telling everything step by step and I'll not leave anything, okay? So please watch the video till very end to be fully clear with this topic, okay? Because I saw on YouTube that there is no clear or not much clear videos over there. So I thought it's better to explain each of the steps so that no doubts remain, okay? So let's start with it. So the first step is you will get this right. Then from that you need to determine that how you'll find the D0 matrix, okay? So to find a D0 matrix, you need to count the number of vertices you have. So in this case, you have 1, 2, 3, 4, okay? So if you have 4 vertices, then you will make 4x4 matrix. Okay, if you have 5 vertices, then you will make 5x5 matrix, and if you have 6 vertices, then you will make 6x6 matrix. So in this case, 4x4 matrix. Okay, then what you need to do is, in your diagonal places you need to place 0, because the distance is 0, right, from a particular vertex to that same vertex. So we are keeping 0 over here because that is the minimum, because you can see from A to A it is 0, from C to C it is 0, right? Now for other we will find, and if we don't have a vertex of, or if we don't have a way from there, then we'll keep infinity, okay, for now. So a to b is your infinity, right? So we'll keep infinity. Then if we see a to c it is 3, okay? Then a to d it is infinity, because there is no way, because it is a directed graph, right? Next is B to A. So if we see B to A, it is 2, right? You can see this. Then B to C is no way there, you can see, because it is a directed one. So it is going but not coming back. So it is infinity again. Okay, and B to D is also infinity. There is no arrow only. Okay, then same like this, C to A. You need to be very careful, okay? If you do one mistake also in your D0 matrix, then whole of your solution will suffer, or whole of your solution will go wrong, okay? So you need to double check it, double verify it when you are making this D0 matrix. Okay, C to A, if we see, then there is no way, right? There is no way. So it is infinity again. Okay, C to B, it is 7. Okay, C to B it's 7, and C to D it is 1. C to D it is 1. All right. Okay, next is D to A we have 6, right? So you'll keep it like that. Then D to B we don't have any way, so we will keep infinity. And D to C there is no way as well. So what we'll do is we'll keep the infinity over here also, okay? So we got our D0 matrix. Now the question comes is, till how many D matrices we have to find, like D1, D2, D3, how many? So it depends on number of vertices. So if you have 4, then you will go till D4. If you have 5 vertices, then you will go till D5. If you have 6 vertices, then you will go till D6, okay? Accordingly, depends upon your number of vertices. So let's find out D1. Now in this case we have 4, so we'll be finding till D4 matrix, okay? So let's find the D1 matrix. Okay, so now I will not write this. This I wrote for your reference, okay? So now let's take about D1. So what we'll do in D1 is, we'll take the first row and the first column. Okay, and we'll write it like this. 0. 2, infinity, and 6. Okay, and column 3, infinity. Okay, no problem. And now what we'll do is we'll circle this so to remember that it is your D1 matrix main components. Okay, so now we had circled it. Okay, this will be very helpful. Now we'll see how. Okay. Now there is a rule, if there is an infinity, okay, and if it is a row in this case, and if this is an infinity, if any element is infinity, then whole of this row will be picked up from here and copied over here, okay? And if any of the column is having infinity, then that particular column from here will be copied to here. Okay, so let's start with the row. So it is 2, so we need to find. It is infinity, so we'll pick the values from here, that is 701. We'll write it like this only, 701. Okay, now I'll see for the column as well. Okay, so it is infinity, so we'll copy it like this, that is 0 and infinity. Okay, next is this, we have to find it out, right? And if we talk about this one, we'll keep it like this only because it has infinity above. Yeah, now remember this infinity is, you don't have to count, only the one that is in circle. That's why I initially said you to circle the first row and the first column as well. Okay, so now what values we don't have these values and these values. Why we did not copy it from the last one? Because we don't have infinity over here, right? So we can't copy these values, we have to find it out. Okay, so to find this one, that is your second row and third column, so we'll add this second and this third one. Okay, so 2 + 3 will be 5. So if we see the older value is infinity, so 5 is smaller than infinity, right? So we'll keep 5. If earlier element is smaller, then we will not replace. If this present element is smaller, then we'll replace. Okay, so similarly we'll find for this also, then it will be 6 + 3, 9. Earlier element was infinity, right? Now next element is 6 + 3, so it will be 9. Okay, so we got our D1 matrix very easily, right? Now we'll find out D2 matrix as well, like this. Okay, so for D2 matrix, what we'll do is we'll copy the second row and second column. Okay, that is this one, 2 0 5 infinity, and second column infinity 0 7 infinity. Okay, now your primary matrix becomes this, not this. Okay, so you'll see this matrix. Okay, this is your here, and again you mark it for your reference. Okay, now again whichever row and whichever column is having infinity, we'll copy it like that. Okay, so we can see clearly that this is having, so we'll copy the elements over here, that is your 6 9 0 as it is. Okay, similarly over here also there is infinity, so we'll copy like this only, 0 3 infinity. Okay, then if we see, then this also has infinity, so we can copy like this also, 1, but no more elements we cannot copy, right? So we have to find this and this. So to find this, it will be 7 + 2, 9. So 9 is smaller than infinity, so we'll copy 9 over. To find this, again this element plus this element, that is 7 + 5, 12. Earlier element was 0, so we'll keep 0. Okay, this is how we need to find. Okay, now what we'll do is we'll find a D3 matrix. Okay, D3 matrix. Okay, so to find the D3 matrix, what we'll do is we'll take the third row and third column, and your primary matrix become this, not this. Okay, so we'll keep 9 over here, then 7 over here, then 0 and 1. Okay, and 3 5 0 9, 3 5 0 9. Okay, I guess it's all right. 9 7 0 1 3 5 0 9. Yeah, it's like a phone number. Yeah, and don't forget to mark, because it removes any chance of confusion, okay, which is very important to have. So this row, this column and this row. Okay, now what we'll do is we'll again apply the same method, but we can see that we don't have any infinity over here, so we need to find, or we need to check all the values, right? So diagonally it will be 0, we know that, because no more smaller distance can exist than 0, right? So we'll keep 0 diagonally. Other than diagonal values, we need to find it out. So for this, we'll check 9 + 5 = 14, and earlier value is 2, so we'll not replace, we'll keep 2 only. Okay, similarly we'll check this one, 7 + 3 = 10, earlier value is infinity, so we'll keep 10 over here. Okay, similarly for this one, 9 plus 9 will be 18, but earlier value was 6, so we'll keep 6 only. And for this one, 7 plus 9 is your 16, right? Earlier value is infinity. You can see it is infinity, so we'll keep 16 over here. Okay, then we need to find for this one, 1 plus 5, 6. Earlier value is infinity, so we'll keep 6 over here. And if we count for this one, 3 plus 1, 4, right? Earlier value is infinity, so we'll keep 4 over here as well. Okay, and in the D4 matrix, what we'll do is, though now we know that we have got our result, all infinity points have gone away, still I will say you suggest you go till D4 matrix, okay, because this is a general method, okay, that you have to count, go till the number of vertices you have, okay. So now we'll add the fourth one, that is 6 16 9 0 1 6 4. Because sometime you may get a smaller distance, in that case you need to replace the value, okay. If the examiner had kept situation like that, then you'll be gone case. So you go till, always go till last, okay. Diagonally again 0, okay, diagonally we don't need to see. Then other than diagonal values we'll check, we have all the values but we need to check whether we have smaller distance or not, okay. Then 6 plus 1, 7, earlier is 9. See, we got it over here. So it will be 7, the updated one. Okay. If we see for this one, 16 plus 1, 17, earlier is 7. So we'll keep 7 over here. That is all right. Now what we need to find is for this one. Earlier is 2. And 6 plus 6, 12. So we'll keep 2 only. Okay. Then we need to find for this one as well. 16 plus 4, 20, earlier is 10, so you'll keep 10 over here, okay. Then 9 plus 6 is 15, earlier is 5, so you'll keep 5. Then 9 plus 4 is 13, earlier is 3, so we'll keep 3. Okay, and now this is our final matrix, okay, and that's your answer of Floyd-Warshall algorithm. Okay, so this is how you can find all paths shortest, okay, shortest distance. So this is how you'll be finding, okay. So this was all about example on Floyd-Warshall. If you have any doubt, you can comment down and I'll help you as soon as possible. And as I promised you, this has been fully clear to you, right? If not, then comment down, okay, please. So thanks for watching.